Wow, how things are good, man. Good. Cannot complain. Working on the things, you know. Working things out. How about yourself, man? What have you been doing? What have you been playing? How are you? I'm First Banana. Oh, yeah, you are. I'm very good. Thank you for asking. Hope you're good as well, Banana. I wanted to make my second ever YouTube video with a darkness glitch in a Nier 2, but I couldn't make it work. Sorry for the profanity in the clip. No worries. That's normal. That's normal. Like, you have not watched my clips? Holy shit. Profanity is normal. Absolutely. So I guess everybody's doing great. Yeah, I'm your rage inspiration, right? Right. Okay. Where we have left last time, I think it was the Yatsunokame mission. That's what where I have left it last time. So far, the first part is actually on YouTube, and I guess the people did like it, so it's quite good. I started working yesterday on the... I started working on the breaking combos from my 5 minutes Fist and Tompa video, man. That's so fucking slow. But yeah, I'll finish it. I'll finish it probably till the next of the... end of the next week, probably, or maybe for a weekend. But yeah, it's super fucking slow. There's a lot of explanations, a lot of recording, a lot of stuff. But yeah, it is what it is. So we are back here in a second part of this guide series that I've been doing. So as I said, for the purpose of the guide, I will not do the side missions because they are not important that much for this sort of guide, but you know, people can feel free to do them because they give a bunch of other stuff, such as certain side missions giving you the guardian spirits, then give you some nice juicy items and so on, Kodamas and so on and so on. So not really important for this guide, because what we need bosses, and usually we'll see a lot of bosses in the main missions. However, there are a few bosses here and there in the side missions that I will try actually to cover, but not the bosses that are actually repeating themselves in a side mission. So let us start. What up, Mario? Hey, Sifu, welcome to the stream. How are you doing, guys? So let's start with a Viper Sanctum. So Viper Sanctum is actually pretty good mission, I'm not gonna lie. So here, as you can see here, the mission is already telling you how many times you have cleared it, how many locks of the hair you have obtained. If you wonder what the locks of the hair are, basically those are the ninjutsu or omnio skill points that you can find in the shape of the hair that you consume, hot springs, dark realms, and so on. Here we could see it here as well. We have collected all the lock of the hairs, all the hot springs, we have cleared all the dark realms, we cleared the mission once. Same thing here, just less info. So let's start with our third main mission, the Viper Sanctum. So right on the time for the class, exactly. So I'm doing good, Mario. How about yourself, man? Hope you're good as well. So Viper Sanctum actually is a very first mission in a first region that actually giving you, in my opinion, a pretty nice, or should I say very handy set, which is named Shinto Priest. As you can see, the Shinto Priest chest and legs are actually reward for this mission, and I will actually go for that one, and I will explain why, and why I like, for example, Shinto Priest, and why I would suggest, because it's a super early and you can get it very early in the game. It's a quite nice set to start with. What up, whoa? Yeah, Zealot University, good idea. I like it. We're gonna call it Axe University. I'm pretty sure I never look at that info. I have 300 hours in the game. There you go, Silence. You see? Every time you get here, you'll learn something new. So That's the point here. I'm here, but I'm work, so gonna be lurking. Thank you very much, Banana. Enjoy your work if that is possible. So here in this mission, we're gonna have a lot of poison, a lot of shit like that, but don't you worry, we have things and items to prevent that and cure ourselves. So get back here. I've been explaining all these items on my last stream, but this is the item that we'll need quite a bit in this mission, which name is Antidote. So Antidote basically removes, or let's say cure, the poison when you consume it. However, it doesn't give you any sort of immunity, or, you know, let's say you're immune to the poison after you drink it. So basically just temporary. You drink it, you cure the poison. Poison buildup or poison which is already applied on you, pretty much. So we'll set it here as a shortcut. So, okay, we have a rocks here. We can put it here. Or, yeah, we can put it here. So now when we swap, have it here. You can usually, it's not necessary, but you can always talk to the NPCs a few times at the beginning of the mission, because they usually give you some items. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't, like here. These graves we have spoke of already, benevolent graves, the graves that can actually, that act as a helpers, so NPC that can help you. NPC actually that, which is simulated, you know, from the other player. It says other player grave, which name is Dante, but it's not actual player, it is the NPC left off from the actual player. So let's get back here to the shrine. Yeah, the only thing we miss is a platinum of Neo 2, which I don't have yet. Yeah, that's correct. So right now here, yeah, game is telling me, oh wow, yeah, you can summon visitor if you need help. I'm trying to encourage all the people who are playing this game first time, try to do alone as much as possible of this content and of this game, and if it's really, really, really necessary, you can summon the visitors by dropping your Choco Cup here at the shrine and waiting for them to appear. But it's really not necessary. If you wanna test out something, if you wanna practice more, and you're in the middle of the mission and you don't want to leave because you'll lose your progress, you can always go to the training ground from here, which is quite nice. Hey, what up, Lahala? Welcome to the stream, man. So here, Soul Cores, we have spoke about them on my last stream. For example, I personally do not like adding Soul Cores on my Guardian Spirits from here. I don't know, I don't somehow feel it's... For me, for example, it's way easier that I go here to the Guardian Spirit, press square, which says exchange the Soul Cores, and then from here, I know how many Soul Cores I can add and actually how many space I have for the Soul Cores. We've been having Enki. I'm gonna keep up the Enki because the Enki is super good Soul Core. Very, very good Soul Core. And on top of that, this Enki here has the Yokai ability Key Pulse. If you wonder what the Yokai ability Key Pulse stat is, actually this stat allowing you to Key Pulse using Soul Cores. Which means, let's say you have a Yokai round to dispel, and you basically use the Soul Core and you dispel the Yokai round, which is quite handy and very nice. However, you don't need more than one. So basically, if you have it on your one Soul Core, and that's enough. You don't need to have it on every single Soul Core that you actually build along with you. So we've been having Mizuki here, Yoki, Gaki. Yeah, Gaki is not bad Soul Core. Let's just speak a little bit about Soul Cores before I move on. So those are the Soul Cores that I have actually got until now. So the first boss Soul Core, Mizuki, which I said it's a super handy, does a lot of damage, but the trigger or triggering it, you should be careful with, because it's a little bit slow, you know, it's coming out slow, but it's very powerful. Yoki, yeah, it's good against humans, small humans or the big humans out of key and so on. You can grapple them, it just looks fancy, nice, you do the, you know, nice amount of damage pretty much. Aki Soul Core. Yeah, it looks like, you know, wow, what is this bullshit? So, believe it or not, there are the certain stats that can heal you when you absorb Amrita. So, Gaki is actually super good. You can toss the Gaki on the enemy, and Gaki will extract the Amrita from your enemy, and then you will heal by absorbing that Amrita. The only one thing that I don't like about Gaki, for example, is his tracking. It's a super bad, so you can easily miss your target. If you try to launch in a target, target can just, you know, dodge left or right or dodge back and you'll miss. So aside of that, it's a quite nice, has a quite nice passive, as you can see. Life Drain, Anima Charge in a Dark Realm, Yoki, as you can see. So every single Soul Core has two locked passives, which are super good. And then Ra, Ippon, as you can see, there you go. So I was spoke about Enki, Ippon, I will not use Ippon in this guide because I do not encourage, nor I want to encourage people using Ippon. It's not a bad Soul Core or anything like that. It just, you know, actually overpowered in my opinion. If you like overpowered stuff, go use it. In my opinion, having the iframes, knocking down the any size of enemy, staggering the enemy, dealing the shit tons of key damage is actually obnoxious comparing to the other Soul Cores. Of course, feel free to use it. I will not use it in this guide, nor because it just super busted Soul Core. And then around the other side, as you can see, basically you cast the Soul Core and then you transform into that big, let's call it fire tornado, and then you can just go around and be in that, let's say, tornado, as long as you have Anima. So if you have infinite Anima, then basically you can be infinite in this soul core, because it is not time limited or animation limited or something like that. Of course, as you can see, it is higher level, multipliers are higher, so the bonuses I'm getting from this one are higher, but as I said I will still stick with the Mizuki and Enki for now. The another thing that I have not mentioned that I want to mention right now, which will be huge or played a huge role later on in the game, is actually you want to match your Soul Cores type with the Guardian Spirit type. What does that mean? What I'm speaking about, I will just explain in a moment. As you can see here, Brute is actually red. So you would like actually to match it by using the red type of Soul Cores. Later on in the game, you can actually change the, let's call affinity of the Soul Core into the Feral Phantom. But for now, I would actually suggest you that. Why I'm suggesting you that, it's quite simple. I'll just go here in an image, shift link tree, and I will show you this. It says, recovers 5% of Anima spend to perform a Yoka ability if it's the type matches the type of your Guardian Spirit. So that's the exact thing that I said there. If you use the Brute, use the red Soul Cores. If you use the Feral, use the blue one. If you use the Phantom, use the purple one. It's not necessary, but it's helping, because the having this passive and using actually that, it's actually quite nice. And you know, it's nice to keep that in mind. So let's not go in any deeper explanations about this. We'll get to that one once, you know, the time comes for that to learn. So let's move now from the shrine. Hey, what up, Sigma? Hope you're doing good, man. Give me a sec, let me just read. Did I miss anything? Are you saying that if you use Mizuki Soul Core, it skill dispels the Yoka realm? No. I was saying this. Let me show you. If you have a Yoka ability key pulse, I'll just demonstrate you that. If you have a Yoka ability key pulse on your Soul Core, here, pardon me. See? Yoka ability key pulse. If I can go here, yeah. It's going to activate key pulse when you perform this Soul Core. I'll just show it right now for you, and then I will attend to the reading the rest of the chat. So let me see if I have any. I have not. Well, I cannot show you. I don't have any Yoka pot to summon the Yoka realm. But I will show you as soon as I get to the one of the Yokas. Mizuki useful against enemies with a zero key. Exactly, Mario. I mean, every Soul Core is super useful against the enemies with a zero key. Hey, what up, Sigma? Hey, brother. Ippon broken because of certain things. It's fast, stun enemies, don't cost much anima, I mean, they did increase the anima cost of the Ippon, but yet it's still busted. If you can stagger any size enemy, like it's your out of jail card every time. Every time you're about to get hit or you're about to die or about something happen, you use Ippon and then you get out of that. You know, that's why I'm saying it just broken busted so core. What up, Elon? And then it's weird. Anima bonus on a saturated enemy is but applies fire. Oh yeah. I agree with you, Sigma. So there is a lot of things which are, you know, doesn't make sense in this game. But yeah, I think it's more of, let's say you apply water and then you use the an Nerna Soul Core actually to apply confusion, and does that way you just benefits from that, you know, benefiting from getting anima back while enemy has water on itself, and then you apply the fire to keep up confusion and deal additional damage to the enemy, which is maybe not bad, in my opinion. So, you know, but it says anima bonus scorch enemy, not the water enemy. I know, did you mention it says saturated enemy? So it's scorch enemy, which means scorch means enemy under the fire. I don't know, where did you read saturated? So it means if the enemy is under the fire, you will apply actually the fire damage. So Iki has the saturated enemy anima bonus, and actually it's like same as an Enra, but just saturated because it's applying water. So yeah, I thought for a moment that I saw someone using the dodge grub. That was great. I started a new character this weekend to learn Tomfa with agility A character. Of them, I forgot how to Hospungi in weak you are at the start. Also, Mizuki core has a big help in early game. Never used Mizuki is super powerful. Ippon is life. I've been using Ippon with my new character. I'm not ashamed. Yeah, I'm just saying, nobody should feel ashamed. I'm just saying, for this purpose of build, I'm not gonna use Ippon. I explained why. You already explained double elements to increase confusion. I have not, but I will just mention them, you know, when the times get to that one. I did just mention it right now because of the thing that a Sigma mentioned. Fun fact, Ippon can stagger cracked OG when he is on a berserk mode. There are the certain moves that gives the hype armor to the enemies, Sifu, so they cannot be, you cannot stagger enemy then. But bunch of moves can be staggered, which usually you cannot stagger with anything. Applies poison Gyuki but gives saturated enemy damage. Okay, Gyuki is something else. Yeah, Gyuki is weird. Yeah, you're right. A few soul cores are like that. Yeah. There are some weird soul cores. I remember that. That's why I was thinking as well. And Enra is one of them, but it's not. So let's move on here. We have some here, dude, here. Kill this dude and move on further. Here we got some small spirit stones here. So actually here we have two ways where you can go. This is the one way, this is the another way. Both of them are connected actually. It's absolutely your choice. However, here you have a dark realm which you want to dispel. So if you're not comfortable with the dark realm, if you don't like the dark realm, if you having trouble with a enemies Yokis so far, we can always take this way here. They're going to lead you to the same space. So here, since I like the dark realm, I'm going to get here and actually clear and dispel the dark realm first, and then I'm gonna get back to the other side. So always, as I said, check around, look around. You want to find the Kodamas, you don't want to miss the Kodamas. So there is one Kodama here, so let's go pick that one first. So we're gonna go afterwards. The Gyuki is a really good soul core to be underrated. Yeah, it is. So I did mention on my last stream, you don't want to fight a lot of enemies at once, because especially if you are new to the game, this game is not slow, this game is pretty fast. If you don't know what are you doing, or if you don't know how to handle multiple enemies, or especially if you don't know their pattern, you should not fight more than one enemy at a time. If you run into two enemies or trigger two enemies at once, try to run away and try to kite one by one enemy to you, because that way you will not die. So as you can see here, we have two enemies here. You could see it here actually, that you have actually been here. See, there is a his, there is a head of his. You can see it also here. So if you try to rush through here, he'll try to stab you with spear, and trust me, he will succeed in that and kick the shit out of your key. So you might try not to rush, you know, just look around, slowly move, and then use the attack that I taught you off, like hold your block to sneak around, you know. He still see us, of course, but it's better than just a run there and get hit by him. Quite easy. Just did like a one heaven flash, knock him out of key, switch to the strong, to the high stance, strong attack, and grapple him to death. So there is our first Kodama in this mission. So since I have started this way, let's go this way. When you're fighting these guys with axe, you want to be careful. So basically, you don't need to do anything special against them. They consume a lot of stamina when they try to hit you. So, you know, hide their attack, dodge back. You can see that they spend a lot of ki. Approach them when they're out of ki. Grapple them. Easy peasy. What you don't want to stand in front of his face and try to block. If you try to block that move, he gonna smash your face with that axe. I mean, he will kick you out of key for sure. So, as I said, just hide their attacks, knock them out of key. Wait for them to get out of key, because they will pretty fast, because they're using the axe, and you know that they spend a more key. So now, as you can see, we've cut actually two enemies. What I want to show you right now is this dude here. You don't want to get grabbed by that. If he grab you with that one, that's instant death. Instant death. So I just wanted to show you that. Be aware of the when you knock your enemies in a critical condition. If you wonder what a critical condition is, you see, this is critical condition. So enemy HP is blinking. That means the enemies are in a critical condition. When the enemies, in this case humans, are in a critical condition, they tend to do the burst attacks. Burst attack of the ninja, it's equal to instant death. You cannot survive that. You might survive it if you have 10k HP. You might survive it. But right now, at the beginning, it's instant death. So yeah, be aware of that one. Before I move any further here, I'll just pick up this item and let me just read the messages from the chat, and then I will actually attempt to get up here and clear all that thing that I mentioned before. I definitely see why the people love Tomfa. Tomfa is much fun, also very easy to learn. Tomfa is a bastard against all normal enemies. Only bosses have enough ki to withstand the fight. Back emo. I use Yukin adapts additionally damage bosses after saturated enemies, but I don't use it out of depths. No, only Tomfa fast attack. Speed weapon and your weapon arts is to cancel at any time. Yeah, you speak about Kanagi, Mario. The Thousand Tongues is a pretty busted parry with Tomfa, and impenetrability staggers humans very easily. Yep, on humans, but doesn't work anywhere else, sadly. One question, Zilad, in your experience, what weapons with imbue corruption will apply corruption faster if adding the corruption to the certain skills? Okay, let me see if I have any weapons so I can show you. But I doubt that I have any weapon with corruption, but let's see if we are happy. If we are lucky. I don't have, sadly, but the higher the imbue value, so let's say imbue corruption plus 8, the higher that value is actually, the faster will apply the corruption. Also, if you have that accumulation percentage and you have that same stat on your guardian spirit, it will apply confusion faster. So you know, there is this weapon has, let's say, plus 5 imbue corruption, the other one has a plus 5, and one apply faster, the other not. No, they both should apply at the same rate. Unless they have some other or special perk, you know, lock perk that the other one does not have, pretty much. But yeah, if you've been speaking about adding corruption in Arcana, about green skills, I'll just mention them in a few minutes. I basically do not suggest people using Arcana or the green skills. The reason why is actually they take a lot of your ki, and the outcome, or let's say the reward from that in particular green skill that you add, is basically not that good, in my opinion. Again, people can feel free to use it, but again, it's... So Heaven Flash into the... Bye-bye. Into the Sworky. Easy peasy. Okay. It should, Sigma. Because you have it on that certain skill, yes, it should. Let's say you put it on a Night Rain. If you use Arcana of Corruption or Arcana of Water on your Night Rain, Night Rain will actually apply the Water or Corruption faster. And it must, because you have used that particular Arcana on it. But if your question is, if you have a Corruption weapon and you put Arcana of Corruption on your skill, will it apply then faster? That's a good question, which I'm not sure actually. Will it or not? I doubt it will, but you know, we'll try it. We'll try it and test it out at some point. Yeah, adding green skills to the certain adding those green things, I'll just show you in a moment. I have not mentioned that last time, but I'll just mention it right now. Let's get back to that one, then we'll just move. So as you can see, the certain skills here have the custom active settings, and right now I think it's still grayed out that I cannot show you because I don't have any of them unlocked. But you can see near every skill you have a circle where you can add actually a custom active skill. That custom active skill comes with a certain increased key consumption, and it's giving you the certain bonuses. It can, let's say, put a certain element on your skill, not weapon, skill. So let's say I put it on the EI quick draw, and then let's say I put as example Arcana of Water, then only this skill will do the water damage. Other skills will actually do the corruption or any other element, or no element if my weapon doesn't have any, pretty much. So as I said, when I learned the first one, I will just show you exactly how you know how much key it's consumed and all that things. Gonna knock out these rocks so you can just pick up some things. You can try it out. You can try it out now, Sigma, and see. So I have actually get here from this side, and I've got behind the Gaki, because this Gaki here is actually tossing the bombs on you if you're approaching from the other side. What you want also to be careful, you wanna, as I said, always look around, because there are always some Gaki hanging out like this one here. And if you get here, oh, let me pick up this item, the Gaki jump on you and eat you. You might not die, but he will transform into the bigger version of himself, and then you will have trouble killing him or fighting him. So be careful, look around. Use your bow as advantage. And we are here, but yet we cannot open the chest. So yeah, let's go down. Hey, what up, Rayclaw? Welcome to the stream, man. Have a beginner question. Would you kindly provide an answer, please? Yeah, Azura, you can get the hell out of here, man. Very often. So another Gaki here. Yeah, let's level up our bow. Another Gaki here slipping. Don't need to fight him if you don't like. Use your bow, especially in a base game. And this dude here, as you can see, yeah, since you see no other big yokai here, it's obvious that he's actually the holder or the host of this Dark Realm here. So by killing him, you will actually dispel the Dark Realm. The info about Dark Realm I have actually gave you on my last stream. So I have spoke of what does actually the Dark Realm do, why it's important and how to act, what to do in the Dark Realm and so on. As you can see there, the Gaki just knocked me with that leg attack and almost knocked all of my ki on my block. So yeah, it's not also, sometimes it's not really even smart to try to block his attacks. So okay, I can get from behind. See, he didn't notice me until he turned. So okay, we have a, I think this is the first time we are meeting the yokai with axe. So he's acting pretty much similarly to the yokai with the with sword, pretty much like the same moves, same follow-ups, with exception that this dude with axe hits like a fucking truck. There you go. You seen that follow-up? That could be very, very deadly. So when you fight this dude, don't rush. Wait for him, observe your enemy. You want to see and know what he does. When he does this move, you can just dodge through him. You can burst counter it, you can dodge through him. You know, either of these works. So as I said, he has the leg kick. He has the hand. You know, he will try to smack you with his hand. Follow up with an axe slash. Again, he does the burst attack. Watch this. If you want to approach him from the back, he will turn and try to hit you. So be aware. Yeah, again, pretty much. So as you can see, after this you have an opening, right? Opening biggest house. Don't go after this one because you never know will he follow up with a hand attack or not. You see, that's the one. You never know, as I said, because the Neo enemies do not use the certain pattern that they observe, you know, in order like in the other games. So you don't want actually to believe them every time they're gonna do the same thing, because they will not. So let's see again. Yeah, you got even that lag kick. So as you can see, slightly a little bit more moves than actually Ora Yoki with a sword. You don't want to get hit by that. And he can follow up with another attack after that one, so you never know. So yeah, let's get back here. Either counter or dodge. If you want to dodge through him. Dodging his side attacks, basically just dodge on the side left, would be nice with the boss right hand, pretty much. This is the funny thing, for example, you can dodge through him and you can still actually counter him with a brute, but with a phantom or feral you cannot do that. So watch like this. Pretty funny, right? So opening, use it as advantage. You can do the follow. There you go. You see that follow up? So you think he is finished with the combo, but no, he has a follow up, and that follow up can kick your butt. So be aware. Again, let him do the attack. Opening. Let's go to high stands to hit him in a horn. Destroy the horns. Now, since we have actually, you know, destroyed a lot of his HP and ki, you don't want to be greedy and try to kill him right away. Move back and then actually wait for another opening to strike. Let him finish. Try to knock him out of ki. So yeah, don't be greedy, wait for your openings. Until you learn the enemy moveset, then you can actually do whatever you want. Then you can be aggressive, greedy, do whatever you want. But on the beginning, especially when you are not knowing the enemy moveset, don't be too greedy. You know, you want to be careful, watch what are you doing, and so on. Let me see what you guys been saying. Favorite calling enemies is lol. Okay, let me see. Let me see, what up, Samurai? Sigma bro, I have watched the video, they are amazing, man, you are the beast. Elmbe, how are you, man? Good to see you. Ezra, how good is you? Well, you just practice some already. There you go. It will apply faster depending on the corruption accumulation you have. I'm good, dude. Just learn. I just need to learn to play and blame whatever. Make a mistake like Zealot, exactly. Hope you like doing good. Read that. Cyber, I'm good. Super busy work day. What up, God? Is this a place where the washed up players get it? Yeah, exactly. Not a play. Make sure you yell bullshit in the top if you. Exactly, Azura. Yeah, you see, Azura is just teaching you the best things. This is how the master plays the game. And I just smack myself in the face when I die. You know, face palm, right? Real master inflict. That's what I have noticed, but never properly tested. So I have a 200+ sentence charge. So I get into out of it awakened state so often. I don't use Arcana and corruption skills. I don't even use Arcana at all, Sigma. Even on a Dream of the Neo. So yeah. I laughed so hard when someone on Discord was having trouble with a Neo and Zilla was like, link his 6 hours video beginner guide. Exactly. No, he was, it was a hit. He actually started the game and he was in the third region, God. Yeah, the guide looks like, you know, wow, it's a 6 hours guide, man. It's not 6 hours, it's just a stream and I have separated everything in a section so people can navigate. I was just going through everything, explaining everything slowly. If I was creating the videos, it would take me who knows how many videos and all of that shit. This time, this way, it's way easier, in my opinion, and this is how I like to make a guide. I haven't a noob how I can get better, Master Zealot. Yo, just get good, man. What up, Mario? Need to finish your college first. Yeah. Don't know which is which. We have two new demons. Hey, Toshiro, welcome to the stream. Hope you're doing good. Hey, Momi, welcome to the stream, man. That answer the question, then see if it thanks. I know, it's just funny to see 6 hours video link. I know. I mean, somebody also on a Facebook was asking, and I posted, and he says, "Oh wow, 6 hours video." I was like, "Okay, dude, look at it. Look in the types timestamps. You know, there are fucking sections. I have not put a fucking 6 hours video and left you over. Look by yourself and find what you need, though." So anyway, we got here the mimic chest. I've been explaining last time how you know it has a 3 strips on the side or in the front, however you want to see it. You see it whistle. And just repeat the actually animation or the emote or whatsoever gesture that actually your clone does. So he does the warrior oath, just repeat it, and he just leaves being happy. If you don't like him, you can go behind him, you can stab him in the back. Okay, we got a Mujina soul core, pretty cool, right? Nice, sweet. So we have dispelled this dark realm so we can move further. People might think that we are trolling them. I never troll, but yeah. Don't kill Mujinas or bosses to get a 50% of the facts. Yeah, exactly, God. Yeah, they do. They do for sure. Another well. In Neo 1, those wells used to give you Weston all the time. Pretty much, like 90% of the time. But in Neo 2, somehow that changed sometimes, especially in a dark realm. Be aware, if you see the well, like this, and if you knock it, you can get the Kappa can get out of it, and you don't want to fucking see the Kappa in the dark realm, especially when they start to spin because they are different in a Neo 2. We got Sohaya motherfucker here. I bet nobody of you like this dude, right? Shoot him in a fucking head because he deserves that, and then just grapple him to that. Pretty much. Okay, we got some Ronin gunplate, Ronin faceplate. So let's see, have we got anything good that we can use? Well, I can use this one, but I'm gonna be agility B, so I will just skip. I can use this one here, which is way better, and I'm gonna be still agility A, which I'm going right away to use. Let's see here, what do we got? Oh, we got a Shinto priest sleeves, nice. Let's use them, because our goal should be here actually to get, if we can, the Shinto priest set. Why I was referring to the Shinto priest is untouched sacred water. I was explaining and saying many times how important sacred water is, because the sacred water is actually speeding up your key recovery by 100%. So it's doubling the speed of Yuki recovery, which is super good. So this set, it's super good beginning set. It's actually, you have a 35% chance that the chance can increase, of course, when you drink it, to get it back, actually to replenish it, which is super good. Damage taken versus yokai, minus 3%, not a big deal, but still 3%, yeah, better than nothing. This is the thing that I actually wanted to point up in this set, super early set, is a life recovery purification. What does that mean? Whenever you dispel the yokai realm, you will get 196 HP back. You can boost this up, of course. If you use a certain clan, you can actually boost that even further. Later on in the DLCs, you can boost that enormously. But yeah, all in a given time. So far, right now in the base game, you can get with this set, with a certain guardian spirit and the clan, you can get around 300-350 to 400 HP back when you clear the yokai pool, which is huge considering how much HP do we have. And damage taken versus yokai, you know, sweet, nice, minus 5%. So this is total of 8% here. And I don't understand actually the third and why the fucking these two are the same, but doesn't matter. Just doesn't matter. Just bullshit in my opinion. Something else should be there, but yeah. You're back on a PC, and the reason why you play on a PC? You asking me, Bob? Because the PC performs super good. And I like the graphics and the resolution on the PC comparing to the PlayStation. What is the name again? Bob Fashional. True, but Zealot was on a PS5 before. Yeah, I did play PS5 because I had to beat the depths on PlayStation 5 God. And I still record the clips on PS5 as well. So all the clips that you have seen in a combo mat or on any of my 5 minutes combos was from the PlayStation 5 because it's for me easier to record there. I basically can just do anything I want and then just press the one button and, you know, have my video recorded. I used the armor set most of the way, NG, for my first character. Very good set bonus. Indeed, Alan. Very good. You can install many mods on a PC. Yeah, that's also another thing. So, yeah, only true gamers have a Neo 2 and playing it for 2000 hours and never platinum it. Yeah, right. That's it, Azura. So, we have got into another dark realm here, right? So we have just got here. You can see, you can already, you don't even need to see, but you will hear this motherfucking Gaki. I will show you one trick. So do you see this? This is like a one trick that you can actually use to check out are there enemies and where the enemies are. So do you see this? I don't see through the door, but my bow is actually telling me this is the enemy and this is the enemy head, as you can see. So this is enemy head and this is the enemy body. So this is pretty nice trick that you can use on the beginning actually to find out if we have any enemies behind the doors, because usually those enemies like to, you know, attack it to the door. See? Just kill that Gaki through the door. So that's like a nice trick carried over from the Neo 1 into Neo 2 to know. Again, you see this dude here? Yeah, that was the dude that we've been actually seeing through the door when I was aiming with the bow. Here you can also find another Gaki. You can sneak up to him. If you sneak up from behind, he will not attack you. But if you just try to run toward him, he will just turn back and attack you. Like this. See? Okay, this time he didn't jump. He just throws the rock on me. But he can also turn and jump. So yeah, try to abuse that. What I have taught you, and I was already mentioning what the Gaki does in the Dark Realm, so be careful. The Gaki, whenever you knock the Gaki out of key, the Gaki will puke out the paralyzing pull in a Dark Realm. That's 100%. There is no, sometimes he will, sometimes he will not. 100% he will do it always in a Dark Realm. We get here. The trick I just told you a moment ago. You shot him in the head. And you have knocked quite big portion of his key, right? And this is the Aberrant Soldier. I don't think so we have met this enemy in earlier. So this is our first time that we have actually met this enemy. So it's actually, it will become just quite common casual enemy. I will just try to explain his moves. So as you can see, it's a yokai pretty much like the human that has become the yokai. He can shoot with this, let's say, corrupted hand. He can shoot on you, so you wanna be careful. When he pull out that spear, he has a pretty goddamn huge range. So you also wanna be aware of that spear attack. You don't want to be too close to him, maybe, or I mean, you can try to block it. That works as well. You can also block this one, but as I said, I'm not suggesting too much to people that they actually try to block, especially on a beginning of the game, because they can knock you out of key. So I'll just show you one funny thing. So you can try to lure him out the Dark Realm and fight him, see what happens. So if you go too far from the Dark Realm, usually the host from the Dark Realm will actually disappear and get back in the Dark Realm. So if you're having trouble fighting him in a Dark Realm, you can actually get outside of the Dark Realm just slightly and try to fight him here if you have a trouble with your key, with a key recovery, which you usually do. But if you go too far, he will just disappear and get back in a Dark Realm. So now we can just get inside back and start over. So let's get back to him. Okay, I just forgot about this. But yeah, he can also toss a spear on you. He can shoot at you. He can pull out that spear and land a few hits here and there. When he does this attack with a sword, he will always follow up with a second one. Move away from this one. You don't want to... you can dodge it, of course, but on your first encounter to him, you'll just, get crashed by that move. So the grapple move he did there, you want to avoid those silver black smoky thing. That's a grapple. You cannot block it, you cannot counter it, you must dodge it. There is no like, I wanna counter that, I wanna block that. No, you cannot, you're gonna get grappled. So he's so often pulling out that spear with his corrupted hand, let's call it that way, shooting with that hand, same hand on you. Also has that, let's say, he can charge toward you and try to hit you with a sword. See, that's the one I was speaking about. You're always going to do two attacks. Either delay first one, then delay the second one, or do the two attacks in a row, quite fast. He likes to go, he likes to retreat as well. Usually he retreats there to shoot at you, or actually to shoot a spear at you. So you want to be careful. So watch again. Move away from this one. You could see that he is actually moving while he performing this move. So you want to be careful. At least move away from him and dodge the third one if it's necessary. So watch this. One, two. He always does two. Either slower or just faster in a row. Now he retreats. When he retreats, he'll try to shoot at you, as I mentioned, or he'll try to hit you with a spear, or even if he wants, he'll try to grapple you. So again, there you go. This was the opening, right? Opening. He's out of key. You want to be careful. Yeah, I got hit there. So you have seen when he was recovering from the out of key state, he actually did that explosion that you want to be careful. You can actually counter that explosion in a base game at least, or perhaps you can just dodge away. So it's up to you. So you can see for a quite small enemy, he has a lot of moves. So that was opening. You're gonna shoot another opening. He's retreating. He's gonna toss the spear or shoot at you. Now you're gonna get back to us. Try to hit me. He doesn't do that hand smack that often, so you're gonna be aware as well. So as you can see, this dude has a lot of moves. A lot of moves for like such a small enemy. If you dodge too early, this one, he'll track you down. So his tracking is quite nice. So be aware not to dodge too early that shot that he does. As you have seen also there, he can pull out a spear, try to hit you twice there. But he does similarly that he does with a sword. So one, two, opening. Funny thing, He acts like a human. So if you try to hit him more than twice, he'll pop up that hand and he'll block the attack. So if you try, watch this. See? You can knock him out of key, of course, like any humans. But what do you want? You don't want actually to keep up kicking or hitting him when he's holding that hand as a block there, because your attack are bouncing off. When your attack are bouncing off, any sort of the skill that you can actually pull afterwards will not work. Because let's say, for example, in order to pull this skill out, I must hit the enemy with a quick attack, right? If my attack deflects, which will not in a high stance, but I'm just saying in a low stance. If my attack get deflected, the follow-up attack or the attack at the end of combo will not work. So that's why I'm saying you don't want to try sitting in front of the enemy and try to kick in him in a fucking block and praying to God that he's key knockoff. I have seen a lot of people who started this game does that. I would not recommend that, because you're gonna get out of key faster than actually you will knock the enemy key, which is holding the block. So if the enemy is holding the block, pull out your high stance and hit him a few times with a high stance attacks, because the high stance is actually piercing through the block. Let me just see. Toshiro, thank you very much for the BDs. So we have killed him. I'll just show you more when we meet more of them, if there are. But you have seen that in the Dark Realm, the Aberrant Soldier has a lot of moves. He can do a lot of stuff. I have actually explained you the few things here and there, what you can do, what he does when he retreat and retreat and so on and so on. How is your no hit run in UE? Oh. Anyway, I can't believe Zilord is using noobs starts to beat enemies outside of the Dark Realm. Yeah, I respect for Zilord. My respect for Zilord. I know, lie. I know, right, man? I was just showing what you can do. That was the thing. Funny, you say noobs straight. I just chuckle about a perfect iframe dodge examples. I think most noobs will get hit by everything. What up, Grandmaster? You know, in inspiration, a lot of high skill gameplay noobs don't possess. When I'm trying to get her weak teammates and adapts, I don't know, okay. Are you going to use the Odachi? Yeah, I will use the Odachi as well, see if I'm having the Odachi and Katana. But I'm just trying to play mostly with Katana, because Katana has certain skills, and you know, if I level up the Katana to the certain level, the other weapons will level up way faster. So yeah, I'll just switch from time to time and use Odachi as well, which I did last time. Thank you for the lurk. Anyways. So let's move on here. Let's pick up all this juicy item here after we kill the dude. Ninja Lock, remember? Summon a Scandal. And some gear shit here. So let's get back here. We got Ninja Lock, which is going to give us another a ninja skill. Last time when I was picking, you have seen me that I have learned Shuriken. I usually don't use Shuriken, but for a people who begin the game, it's not bad to have a Shuriken as a source to kite the enemy toward you, or just lure the enemy to approach you, because you can have unlimited amount of Shurikens. I mean, unlimited. As soon as you rest at a shrine, you will have your Shurikens back. Also, there are the other ways actually to replenish them or have unlimited way of them, but you know, just nice item that you can use at the beginning. Using the poison Gale Nut Brute, it's only good if you want to level up your ninjutsu faster. Why? As you can see, I apply poison on my weapon here. So when I apply poison on my weapon here and I'm fighting certain enemies, the ninjutsu proficiency will build up because I'm using proficiency. Doesn't matter that I'm not using actively proficiency, like I'm tossing shuriken on somebody or tossing some sort of talisman. I'm having the element, not element, because the poison is not the element, but I'm having some, let's say, sort of element on my weapon, which is from the ninjutsu tree that will give me the proficiency for ninjutsu. So this is, for example, pretty nice way if you want to level up your ninjutsu fast, put a poison on your weapon and go around by the enemies, and you're gonna build up your ninjutsu quite fast. Tiger running, absolutely, I see no use on it on the beginning. If you want to move fast around, go ahead, but I would just say it's a waste. And fire gunpowder bombs, you can use them, but again, you have a bunch of bombs that you can get on your way, so I would suggest you get a shuriken first, then you can get the poison Gale Nut Brat, or whatsoever was the name, if I read it incorrectly. So let's learn this one here, so we can actually, you know, level up some ninjutsu and get some nice juicy items from ninjutsu, which I want hopefully to have here, which is the there we go. Just to try to find this one here. So I want this one here as soon as possible. Medicine 7 herb pills is the one I want, and the another one I want is the healing antitoxin pill. If you ever wonder or you think, what the hell is these pills and why I'm actually mentioning them and why do I use them a lot, I'll just explain in a moment. These in particular pills here, comparing to Neo 1, are way different in Neo 2. In Neo 1, they used to increase your resistance to poison. This one, antitoxin pill, and the other one used to increase your resistance to paralyze. However, in Neo 2, they actually giving you immunity. So they act like antidote, they clearing out the poison, and as long as you have that buff on yourself, you are immune to being poisoned. You can basically swim in a poison pool, you can sit in a poison, you can do whatever you want, you will not be poisoned because you have immunity on poison when you drink the antitoxin pill. When you get to the medicine 7 herb pill, when you drink this one, you're immune on being paralyzed. So Gaki pulls can do nothing to you. Enemy that we have not met yet, that we will do, Nureona. She has a lot of paralyzing moves, so she will not be able to paralyze you. So these two, in my opinion, are super, super good and very, very, very useful items to learn first. So that's why I went right now for the poison. And I'm going to attach this right now at the shrine, at the next shrine, and I'm going to run around, you know, with a poison on my sword to build up a little bit of ninjutsu so I can get the antitoxin pills and I can get the 7 herb pills, which are quite good and very, very effective. Especially here in this map, you want to have antitoxin pills. Why? You will understand as soon as we get to the boss or get deeper into this, let's call it pit. I see, awesome. What do you see, Sifu? I'm a noob and I still get hit, but a lot of things, I'm just a bad gamer. Sigma... What the fuck, Sigma, dude? Come on, man. Please. Come on, man. Thank you very much. As I said, this is really not necessary. I appreciate you, brother. Thank you very much for all that support. Thank you very much, man. Was not necessary at all. Any tip for Yoshimitsu in a phantom form? That guy's annoying, always spamming the same attack, I cannot reach him. JL, hey dude, welcome to the stream. He should be in the next mission, I think, so as soon as I get there, I can actually show you. It's quite easy to dodge his moves, because his phantom pattern is basically too repeatable. So he will try to hit you. Basically, how you dodge that phantom is left, right, left. So that's how he tried to hit you. So he land one attack on the right. Pardon me, if you dodge left, right, left, he does it opposite. So what do you want to do? He attack you, you dodge right, the first attack, then left, the second one, then right, third one. So he's actually attacking the opposite of you dodge it. So it's quite easy. You don't want to be aggressive with him, you don't want to get into his face because he can counter you with a phantom or block. So try to dodge those three attacks that he does. Get near him, use the sword key or any other source that you that deals some sort of key damage, and knock him out of key, because they can get out of key pretty easily when they are in these yokai forms. I mean, I'll just explain everything when I get to that boss. So I'll just try to cover every single form if that's possible. Yeah, I did see the info, see it here, but the actual alert didn't pop up. I don't know why. Thank you very much, Sigma. Thank you for sharing, Wadog. No problem. You're welcome. I'm off to bed for... Holy shit, Sigma. Okay, man. Take care, man. Have a good one. Thank you very much, man. Sleep well and take care. No. Thank you very much. Take care, man. I think the gap close attack that he does that trips people up. That's not a big deal. You can just easily dodge it. But yeah. That's true. Take care, Sigma. The gap close attack does a lot of damage. But he usually does after the charge attack, which makes his blades big. So yeah, that's another good thing that a Grandmaster has actually mentioned you. But most of the time he spam that motherfucking three combo hit, which you can dodge. So let's move on, guys. Another, just kill the one, and we have another one here, right? As you can see, if you just try to observe this dude, oh fuck, I'm dead. My bad. This was my first death. Anyways, in case you die, you want to get there and pick up your spirit. Yeah, there you go. This is prone when we die first time. So if you die now again, you will lose all your amrita that you have actually collected until now. What is the good thing, even though that we don't have a guardian spirit here, we just don't have a passive from the guardian spirit, but we still can use our yokai shift counters. We can still use the soul course. We don't need to pick up our guardian spirit first in order to get this thing back. So if we die now, we're gonna lose all the amrita, all the soul cores that we have collected and not purified. I'm speaking about non-purified soul cores. So yeah, you want to be careful. But now I can use this opportunity to show you this item here, which is Summoner Candle, which can save you a lot of trouble. If you're now scared that you will die and you have had actually a lot of amrita and what the hell, man, what I'm gonna do now? Yeah, you can actually take this item here, and this item will just for free bring that spirit back to you with all soul cores that you have actually got. As you can see, collected 4 soul cores. My amrita is back, everything is back. Now I can just get here since we are near shrine. Let's level up and then let's move on back to where we have actually stopped. It's actually the good thing that I die here, so I could explain this as well, because it's important to know it on the beginning. You will die on the beginning quite a lot. So yeah, we got a few other soul cores. Aberrant Soldier. Okay, I will now speak about this soul core here. Is a super duper great, like super duper great. Like, I love this soul core. Efficient yoke ability rolls. It's a quite nice. Not super fucking great, but it's quite decent. This is what I actually want to point out. Anima bonus timely guard. Timely guard. What is timely guard? When you block right before the impact, you will get one anima back. As you are increasing the soul core rank of this soul core, which you can do actually by soul matching this soul core with another soul core, here under the manage soul core menu, so soul fusion. If you have two same soul core types, let's say we have a Yoki, we have two Yokis, level 22 and level 9. I can use this Yoki and I can soul fuse it with this Yoki, and the rank will increase from soul rank 4, soul rank 2 to soul rank 4. So this is how you actually enchanting, making your soul cores be stronger than they used to be. So let's say we have Gaki, you have two Gakis, one is a level 15, the other one is a level 10. You check out, okay, this one has anima movement, okay, I like this one. But what is the fun thing, you see? Watch this. The soul cores that have the skills with this sort of arrow shown here, that will transfer when you fuse them with the other soul core of the same time. Fucking hell, man. So if you... I'll try to explain from beginning. So if you fuse one Gaki soul core in this case with the other soul core that has this type of stat like we have here, that stat will actually carry over to the other soul core, as you can see, as it did here. And yeah, we just did fuse it. Now let's get back here. I will not change still my soul cores, but as soon as the time get, I'm going to swap and pick up the Aberrant Soldier Soul Core because it's quite nice. So now since we are here, let me go and put up some ninjutsu things. Ready Jutsu. Here you can actually set up the items that you have learned in Jutsu and Omnio Tree. Until now we have just learned the Shuriken and Poison. And from the Omnio we have learned Purification. So okay. How much we can use? Three of them. Sweet. Cool. Three of them and set them as a shortcut. Yes. I set them here as a shortcut. Let's go to ninjutsu. How many of these we can use? We can use them. Three of them. Not bad. Right? Let's use three of them. And let's put them here. If you want to use shuriken, you can put a shuriken as well. So yeah. As you can see, here you're changing the amount of the item that you want to have. I can have two of them and then put a two shurikens and so on and so on. But I don't need a shurikens, so I'll just actually do this poison Galnut Brook. Yeah. What's so good on it? What's so good on the soul core? I'll just tell you what is so good. Let me tell you right away. What's so good on the soul core that he mentioned? Yoke ability damage all. This is very good. This is increasing the damage of your yoke abilities, which is quite nice. And this is increasing the item drop rate versus humans, which is not bad. But yeah, this one is quite nice. Quite nice. So okay, let's move on. We have died now. As you have seen, why it's important to try not to die twice in a row and lose the soul cores that you have not purified, because whenever you get to the shrine and purify those soul cores, you will get the... You will actually fill up this bar here, the shifterling bar, that you can see here in a bottom... right. See? Shifting level, soul fragments earned from the resting rites. If you don't want to use some of the soul cores, you can actually just, you know, get rid of them, like I will just get rid of the Ippon, for example, now. And I'm gonna get the certain amount of the soul fragments. So the more soul fragments, the faster this bar fill, and then you can get the shifterling points. Since we got another shifterling point, and now we have access to this, so I didn't mention you, at some point you will get access to this skill. Now we have learned... this one, which is pretty handy, Dark Within 3, it reduces the penalty of your key recovery speed in a dark round by 30%, which is huge. Trust me, it's super good. You don't want to level up this one. We want to level it up, but not right now. Now, what we want, what we would like to have is actually this one here. But it's not that easy, right? Restores 40% of your key when you successfully perform the burst counter. The game is kind of based around the burst counter, so you want to have this. So basically you burst counter the target and you get a 40% of your key back. When you level this to level 3, you can have 100% of the key back, which is super good, right? So what do we want right now? So in order to get this one, it's telling us that we gotta learn this one, Arcane of Lightning, and in order to get or learn Arcane of Lightning, we need to learn this one, which says reduce the depletion of the yokai shield gauge by the 10% when dodging in the yokai form. Not a big deal, but we gotta learn that one. So let's look around if there is anything maybe better that you can actually use at the beginning. Since we here need 3 points, right, and we don't have a 3 points, so instead of just, you know, feeling right away towards this, you might also go for this one if you want. So it says restores 20% of your health when you successfully grapple an enemy while in a yoga ship. So just bear in mind, that doesn't mean when you burst counter your target. It means if you're in a yoga shift and burst counter, then you will get a 20% of HP back. So be aware. So it's written well, so you just gotta understand it correctly. This is not bad. You can learn it, but you will not have that big of use unless you like to spam the yokai shift. This one here, reduce the depletion of the yokai shift, blah 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 blah. We don't need it. We don't need this one either. This one you can get later on. What does this one do? Actually, it's as soon as you trigger the yokai shift, it's going to imbue the shockwaves, which will actually stagger the target that is in nearby you. So not necessary to have it right away. So we said we want to build up toward the special finesse refresh one, so let's start with the demonic dexterity and let's move on right now. Since we have cleared this part here and we can avoid all these humans, we just have just one Gaki here, We killed that Gaki. You have remembered that I told you on my last stream that enemies killed in a Dark Realm never respawn again. Unless you die in a Dark Realm, so they will respawn. So if you kill them all in a Dark Realm and you kill the Dark Realm host, they will not respawn anymore. So this is nice way to avoid all these enemies, all these punk ass humans down there. So you can just avoid all of them, just get here. You know, we skip the nice part and you actually save yourself of dying. Really, man? Really, dude? Really? Kill this dude once again. We have got two elixirs here, which is not bad. Get up here, pick up this item. Wow, nice, 5 arrows. Sweet. And now we move back on the where we have left and die, actually. Quite, these places are quite tight here. So if you have noticed, for example, the funny thing I have done. He shot me, he knocked me out of key. When he knocked me out of key, I'm in a vulnerable state for a certain amount of time, which means I'm taking increased damage. So if you are in a vulnerable state or out of the key state, you'll receive 60% more damage, which you don't want to. So what I did there, for example, he knocked me out of key and I immediately react by using the soul core. Have used the soul core. While in a soul core animation, my key has actually pretty much recovered to the maximum. So I have saved myself from the out of the key state. So remember that when you are in out of the key state, you can use either your counter. Like I could use the brute, feral phantom. That doesn't require you to have any key left, just anima. Or you can use your soul cores, actually, you know, to save yourself from being hit while in that out of key state, because you're receiving the increased damage. Yeah, no worries, God. Thank you very much for the help. I'll try to do it on my own. Thank you for the help. I appreciate that, sir. And you can now gently take a leave. Okay, we have got to the next shrine. Let's level up. Let's see where we have left last time. And let me see if we have any spirit stones. No, we don't have any spirit stones, right? No, we don't have any. Okay, cool. So let's level up. So last time I did equally distribute my points to these stats here. And that's what I'm highly suggesting to the people. So now let's level up. How much points? We have 2 points. Let's put in a courage. 2 more points. Let's actually do it. 1 courage, 1 stamina. I want to focus on courage and stamina, heart and constitution as a first priority, or these two as a first. Second priority, strength, skill, constitution. Just to follow them up, like this is 999, then we have this 888, and so on and so on. Dexterity and magic, absolutely optional. You can have it more than 10, you can, it's absolutely optional, but you can also live with a 6 of them. Not a big deal, not too important. Yeah, this mission looks quite fun. You try to jump down, you will die. So you cannot survive the fall. Later on you will. This is the shortcut that will actually open later on in the game. So now let's move on. You have a lot of these graves on your benevolent graves on your way. So if you really need help, you can summon it. But as I said, try, and I'm encouraging you, try to play on your own. Don't summon the help unless you really, really, really need. So that's my suggestion. If you are just casually going through the game and you don't give a thing, or you don't want to learn it, you know, feel free to summon it, of course. But I'm just saying, try to learn the game. We have seen the item here. As soon as you've seen the item, you want to also always check around if there are any enemies which are maybe hanging there, which is, you know, not unusual in here. So let's move on. Okay, we got another Aberon soldier. So we have killed one and suddenly they have become a regular enemy, right? So you see what I have done? So I will explain what I did. I did a high stance running attack. So what is the high stance running attack, right? So basically, when you hold your X button And I just couldn't shift between the Xbox and PlayStation 5 controller. So when you hold your X button, you actually run it, right? So Neo has a running attacks and you have a dash attacks. So what I was doing here, I was doing the running attack. So I started running. I swapped actually to the high stance and I started running and pressed the quick attack. As you could see, that is how it looks. Thus, I did hit the Abaddon Soldier in his weak spot, which is that Amrita hand, and knocked the big part of his max key. Right after, I followed up with a sword key to get the rest of his key down and actually even knock him out of the max key so I can actually grapple him. As soon as I grappled, he was actually going to recover. As he was recovering, I did launch the EI quick draw and I have finished him off. Yeah. Did you get a PS5? Yes, I have a PS5. Yes. So, as I say, if you are beginner, if you are new, look around. You see this fucker here? He will just gently let you pass him. When you pass him, he will actually get up on a platform and then you are fucked. Because you can easily die here. What you can do, you can shoot the other Gaki, this one will just pop out. Or you can just shoot him while he's hanging there and actually kill him. The funny thing here, what you can do, you can drop yourself here and we can actually drop down. And we can skip the certain part here, but you might drop here, but I'm not sure if you are going to survive and you drop yourself further down. Actually, you should survive. You should survive. So this is, if you want to make a shortcut, you can just jump here on this platform, then jump down. But you have a lot of poison pools, so we will not do that right now. We're gonna get there later to pick up that item. So let's move through here. Okay. This is our first time and that we are actually seeing this enemy. This enemy is looks like a snake lady, which name is Nure Ona. So I'll just try to explain her moves here. Show you the openings and, you know, try to teach you how you can dodge her moves and so on. What is the most OP build for NG plus 4? I'm an Uzumi Susano. So 7 pieces I'm an Uzume and 6 pieces Susano, and you destroy the enemies basically. Susano. I have a build as well, which I did long ago, Momi. It was like a year or so ago, which was named Ameno Susano. It was agility A build. Agility A, toughness A build, should be. So let me just try to... Speaking about Neo to Ameno Susano build. Is it like this? Yeah, there you go. So pretty much you can use that one, Mommy. So let's get to her. Once you get to her, remember the attack I taught you, hold your block so she will not see you if you approach it from the back. This thing here that she just did, yeah, actually can paralyze you. As you can see, it started building up, it does the physical damage and it actually can paralyze you. This burstable attack here actually can paralyze you and then she will grapple you. As you can see, she can also spit a poison on you. Which is quite common. She likes to spam these needles. You want to dodge them. And as you can see, she approached to you and then try to smack you down with her tail. A lot of people have in trouble, especially the beginners, to dodge this. So if you have a trouble dodging this, just hold your block. You'll be able to block. You see, she will not do that much key damage. So just gently hold your block and you're good. You can dodge it, of course, but it's pretty tricky. And if your timing is not good, which is not at the beginning, you're going to get hit, which you don't want. For sure, yeah, you hit me there, absolutely. So let's get back there. So she has so far 2 burst attacks. One is when she does that paralyzing beam. The second one is when she slammed the ground with a tail. Again, her needle bullshit, her charge toward you, block it. You can go behind her and then brute her down if you're using the brute counter. If you're using feral, you gotta wait because the timing is different. This is the attack that she haven't done until now. She can also do that attack. It's quite easy to dodge. What's this? So you see, hold your block. So we did a nice amount of damage. Again, block. As soon as you block, release your block and move around. Needles, dodge them away. Dodge and smack with the brute, if you're using brute. If you use the feral, you're gonna wait for her to shoot a beam, and then as soon as she shoot the beam, you want to feral into her and counter her. With a phantom, basically just timely block, with a, you know, just timely counter it, pretty much. But with brute, you have that actually ability to dodge behind her and actually smack her down with a brute slap, which is quite nice. Hey, Mr. VCK. Hi there. AC Valhalla, Red Dead Redemption 2 for a single player. Please could you suggest me which one to buy? Can you please tell me what game do you like? Then I can just suggest you. I mean, I have not played either of them. But Assassin's Creed seems fine, but it's just getting too repetitive after a certain amount of time. Red Dead Redemption, it's quite big, the game, with a lot of things. It just depends on your preference. There are different guys, different games, absolutely. But yeah, Red Dead Redemption is quite nice. I have never played it myself, but I have heard from the people it's a quite good and fun game. If you like the shooter type of the game, if you like more of the action RPG, you can go for Valhalla. What up, Abud? Welcome to the stream, dude. So yeah, we have killed the Nurevona. I have shown you what she can do, how you can avoid the certain attacks, because I have seen a lot of people having trouble with that. When she not dash, when she approach you and slam with her tail, you know, a lot of people get hit because they try to dodge and the timing is not good. Just block it, and you're good. You will not get out of key. Okay, hatchet motherfucker. We don't like these dudes at all. They can be pretty nasty, can be pretty annoying. Heaven flash into the high stance. Wrong attack to knock him out of key, grapple him and just finish him off. I mean, the Valhalla is not super fast, but yeah, it's faster compared to Redemption. But they are two different games. Why Izanami? What does the offer? Why Matsumi? Izanami, it's good. I mean, it's not for adapts, but it's not bad. It's a not bad build, Grant Master, because of the ability to allow you to survive at 1 HP and insanely fast heal yourself. Let's look around. What do we have here? This is where we need to proceed further. Actually, that's where we have came from. Let's look around. Let's see if there is anything here. Okay, we have a we pick up the loot here. We killed the Sohaya, and now we want to move further. Why playing the other games when you have a Neo? Right. Yeah, saying the Abud who said yesterday Ninja Gaiden 2. I'm having a lot of fun with Ninja Gaiden 2 than with Neo, right? Right, Abud. Yeah, Mozart is pretty correct. If you play with a critical build, so Izanami is super useful. Let's move here. Why I was telling you, always look at the top of these fucking caves. See this bitch here? There is a one funny thing. If you use the gun and try to shoot her, she will hear the boom of your gun or the matchlock whatsoever or a cannon, and she will drop down. But when you use the arrow, she will not hear. What do you want to do? You don't want to shoot her just in the body, you shoot her in the head to deal some max key damage. Watch this. I knock her out of max key with only one
strong attack of the bow. I mean strong attack, strong arrow of the bow. I put in a grapple state, just one strong bow in her head while she was hanging there. So it was quite easy to put it on. No, no, I know, I'm just kidding. I like Nioh 2 and Ghost of Tsushima. Game of the year? Wait, Tsushima was not a game of the year 2020. It was the bullshit Last of Us 2, right? If I'm not mistaken. I'm well aware. Might be mistaken. I think it was the bullshit Last of Us, which was the game of the year, which I would never understand. Hey, what up, Spawn? Welcome to the stream, my brother. Which I would never give a fucking game of the year, but you know, just a fucking fan base. So you have seen, wow, where the fuck this coming from? I have not seen any fucking way to get here, right? So let me just get back there and show you what did we miss. He fell to that. So he see this thing here. He tried to get down the loot, and he fell off of the dead. So don't be like this guy. You cannot drop to this loot from here. If you wanna get this loot, you gotta drop from here. Yeah, I know. For me as well, the Ghost of Tsushima is the game of the year. I mean, I personally love Nioh 2. Nioh 2 is also amazing. So, in my opinion, Nioh was launched on a PlayStation in 2019. That's the game of the year for me on a PlayStation, and on a PC in 2019, 2020, it's a Ghost of Tsushima. And a story. What up, Taco? What up, mate? So I was speaking, how do we get down for these items? This is what we missed. The last time when I met the Nurikabe or the Living Wall, I was explaining you, always look around for some revenants here that they die to the Nurikabe. But the thing is here, why we don't see the revenants here? Simple example. Not much people notice this wall here. So right now, since we don't have any revenant to tell us what was the wrong color, we have only two chances to guess. What is matter is the color, not the emo that you do. What do you want to do, for example? I'll just try to show you a few of them. Let me see what I have here. Let's try the yellow one. Okay. The yellow one is not. Okay. So right now, since it's not a yellow one, it is either blue or red. We don't know. And he's mad already. So what I suggest you, let's use red. Why I'm using backflip right now is that I move away from him. And as you could see, it was not a right color. It was blue. So right now we gotta fight him. So let's see what attacks he got. He can just toss the rock on you, pretty much, with his left or right hand, as you can see. Quite easy. If you approach him, he'll try to slam you down with his hand. Either left, right, or with the bot hands. So you wanna be careful. Approach him. Move away. His hitbox are kinda awkward. So I would suggest you to move back. Move away, let him hit, open him. So when he does that burst attack, you can just dodge on the left or right. And counter him. So when I did counter him, he got somehow in some sort of weak state. But you should not underestimate him when he was in that state, because he's recovering by lapping like his hands like this, or trying to hit you, and then he does that overhand slam attack on the ground. So why did I use the backflip there? The simple reason why was actually to move away from the wall. So if it was a wrong color, I have actually made some distance between me and wall, so I can run away. But that's the reason I did use that particular emote there. So as I said, emote, it doesn't matter. What is matter is color. I tried the critical ability in adapts, it's not good. Not much, man, just doing my shit. Working on the second part of the guy, Taco. Hope you're doing good, man. So this is why I went here. We got Omnia Mage Lock. You love that, right? Let's see what we can learn. Fire Talisman, Water Talisman, Lightning Talisman.
Oh shit. What are you gonna learn right now, huh? So I'll learn Lightning Talisman. Why I'm going to learn Lightning Talisman, I'll explain you in a moment. If you wonder. But the only reason why I want to learn the Lightning Talisman is because of the Gust Talisman. Which we have no we have no access right now, but we'll have access at some point. What does the Gust Talisman do? Actually, it's repelling back the enemy range attacks to them. It's a quite nice, quite handy to know at the beginning, so you can use actually to. So let's say a Baron soldier shoot at you that projectile. Every sort of projectile will be actually sent back to the caster. So I will not, you know, level this up because it's not necessary at all. I'm not gonna get resistant talisman, which I can, because I'm gonna get those pills from the ninjutsu tree that I was mentioning. So I'm gonna go for the lightning talisman and I'm going for the gust talisman after that. Here we have our life leech talisman, water shot, not a big deal, fire shot, fire stop talisman, the vigor rate talisman. Like I would say the gust is better than any of them, and this is very good talisman that you will need a lot on your playthrough, which is light stop talisman. So yeah, let's go for the lightning talisman. Repealed, thank you Mario. Alright, nice, congrats. So here, since we have actually done the dojo, we have unlocked the more skills. What are we gonna get right now? Leaf glide we don't need, I said. Sword of imitation or meditation, which I just killing around, you don't need at all. It's like a pretty advanced skill that you don't want to. Sword of celerity. This might not be bad to learn right now. It's a quite nice follow-up after the after the sword key. Or you can go for the EI quick draw too. But I would rather go for this one. So you have option to go for the swallow wing. Sword of celerity, sword of imitation, which is not required. Thank you very much, Taco. Thank you very much, mate. Swift step, which I said we will not learn. Don't need a swift step because you can use either heaven flash or a swift step. You cannot use both of them at the same time. Here these are locked, so we cannot use any of these, so let's go for the Sword of Celerity at this point. What is the Sword of Celerity? That was the Sword of Celerity. Right? That was it. Thank you very much, Taco. Oh wow, don't miss Kodama. That's why I'm saying, try to carry with yourself Kodama, Natsuki. Numeri, this is level 1, I don't care because it's level 1. I see the Kodamas and I'm having the elixir efficiency and a quite nice stat on it. There might be some better stat accessories, but trust me, nothing will give you that. You know, getting here and there defense is not a big deal comparing to the actually those passives that actually Kodama Natsuki giving you. Let's get here. Let's pick up the Kodama and let's move on. As you can see, I'm still not healing. I'm having 900 HP and I'm not healing. I would not suggest you to waste your elixir just like that. If you wonder why do I not use my elixir right now to heal myself up, it's not necessary. I cannot get one shot unless I get grabbed. I mean, the grabs are pretty strong and that's actually the strongest enemy attack, which is normal that it is going to one shot you. But now I'm not gonna heal until my HP drops below, let's say, 60 or 50%. Here, you want to be careful because you can, as you can see, you have a Gaki here, and I showed you already that trick. Use your bow, aim through the walls or through the box, and you can actually find out to have more enemies. If we kill the Gaki right now, the Aberrant Soldier is gonna be lured as well, and if the Enki is nearby, he's gonna get at us as well. So watch this. Wait for Enki to go away. Okay, cool. He didn't get triggered. And now, wait for Enki to get back. And then again go back on his way, and after that you can actually shoot that Aberrant Soldier and go kill him. You don't want to fight more enemies at once, especially if you are new to the game. Okay, now we move away. You have seen what I did there. I run into him with a Heaven Flash, and he surprised me with a burst attack. I couldn't counter it because I did not have time, but I have survived. Now we can take the elixir and heal up. Let's pick up all this loot. I have already explained you how do you fight Enki, so I don't need to do it again. Watch this. If you try to approach him from the back, he'll not get easy on you. So we got open in here, right? Try not to dodge this one. It has a huge hitbox. You're gonna get hit. So try to move away from that one. Now you're gonna slam the ground a few times here and there. Now you're gonna get up. He would either toss the spear. If you're far away, he's gonna toss the spear. If you're in below him, he'll actually just hit the ground. Right? This was quite easy. We use that new skill that we have learned. Move away. Approach. And we got a Shinto priest shoes, which is quite nice. And let's put them. So I was already explaining how you fight that enemy, so I just did again, just fast recap. You get a 30% damage when you're in a critical life. This is melee damage. Take your time, Sifu. Yeah, the true Mozart. I tried it out. It's a quite good, but you can actually get over 150. Yeah, over 150. Actually even more damage in a critical state. It's quite OP, but I just don't like being one shot that easily. I mean, Izanami will send me once, but not all the time. So let's get back here. Also, this will always heal you to maximum, so that's why I'm saying don't waste your elixirs if you don't need to. They are very, very important. It's very important to save them, not to drink them every few seconds. Always look around. Let's pick up this loot. We are getting down deeper into this pit. Oh, another Gaki. Cool, he saw us. Another Gaki there. We have two Gakis there, right? All right. See the damage? That was the Mizuki Tolkor, which is quite nice. Yes. So, okay, I didn't mention you earlier, the shortcut. So let's go and open the shortcut, which is connected to the shrine from here. So here you have one human, actually two humans. Yeah, so if you don't like or not comfortable fighting both of them at the same time, go away. The other one will just go back to his place. Kill this one here first and then go back for the other one. Yeah, this one was the archer. He usually doesn't move or follow you. You can just sit here. Okay, nice. Let's get back here. Another. Okay, let's kill this motherfucker Sohaya with the hatches. I did explain what he can do. The funny thing with the ghast talisman that I showed you, that repel back the range attacks, you can actually repel back that fucking hatches on him. So I did Morning Moon, I got out of key, I went right away into the Enki and I finished him off. So yeah, be aware, these guys are no joke. They can be pretty rough, pretty annoying at the same time. So you actually don't want to go on them very easily. So we have opened the shortcut, this shortcut connecting us to the shrine that we actually been here. You can rest if you want, I will not. I don't like to play the Depths of Stone either. So here, you can drop down. From here, pick up this item. Put up smash. And we got our first Togemaru, guys. Togemaru is actually very, very, very good weapon. Togemaru is actually super early weapon with a corruption imbue. And well, we are super lucky, we have got as well the Corruption Odachi, so I can consider we are super lucky. We have so Corruption Odachi and Corruption Sword. So, okay, what is so special about corruption and why we're getting so early in the game corruption first? Why we're getting corruption weapons so early in the game? Well, I have no clue. Probably they try to introduce that yokai weapon because that's a yokai weapon. So what corruption itself do? Applying corruption on a target, you will benefit from many things. So one of the things actually is you're stealing the key from your enemy when you're attacking them. The other one is the enemy cannot apply any sort of element on their weapons in terms of, let's say, human enemies who like those highest to apply the fire. They will not be able to apply any element on their weapon. You're dealing increased key damage slightly, but yeah, you're doing some increased key damage, and when your weapon get fully charged, it will get into the awakened state, and while in awakened state, you will deal a quite good, actually quite great damage to your targets. So now you can see here we have some sort of statue which is destroyed, and you can see that a poison is missing here, right? We got a poison pool here, poison pool there, but there is no poison here. And why the hell there is no poison here? There should be probably poison pool, because we can see it was recently drained. So since this statue here is destroyed, the poison pool has disappeared. In this particular mission, there are few statues that you want to destroy. One of them is here, as you can see it. One of them is hidden inside here, and one of them is actually either here or somewhere else. Maybe one of them is here. They differently placed depending on the map in this main mission. So once you destroy the statues, you're gonna get rid of this poison pool here. But you will not only get rid of this poison pool here, you will also get rid of the poison pool in a boss fight. So the boss that you are going to encounter in this mission is obviously poison user boss, and since this map is, as you can see, made out of a lot of poison pools, the boss itself will have a poison pools in the area which you want to avoid, right? So you want also to destroy all these statues. You're gonna get achievement for that as well, but you want to get rid of them so you can actually clear all these things and, you know, navigate easily through this one. So we have here Rayona. I've explained you up there how you fight Rayona, what she can do, but I'm gonna just repeat: dodge, brute opening. Okay, her hair attacks. Now you're gonna try to hit me, I block. Don't forget to key pulse. Try to use the N key to maximize your max key damage. Sometimes she can follow up with a tail sweep after the hair sweeps, so be aware. Watch. She does that, you go behind. Now she's moving away. As soon as she back off, she's gonna charge toward you and try to slam you with a tail. Yeah, quite easy. I was just repeating what I've been saying earlier. So just some practice and you'll be good against her. When she does that tail sweep, block it. Don't try to dodge it. You can dodge it, of course, but you're gonna get hit most of the time. Scampus, yeah, let's have some Scampus here. And look at our Anima, it's actually passively regenerating. Gaki here, kill him. Another Gaki here, let's kill him as well. Anti-paralytic needles. What is funny thing, you can shoot him with your arrow in his Amrita hand, and as you can see, you will knock off his max key. They will actually do the quite big amount of damage to his max key. You also want to be aware of another thing. I'll just try to kill him first. So yeah, you want to crush this as fast as possible. Try avoiding the poison to build up on you. Of course, since this is Neo and you can always expect having the motherfuckers who are gonna toss the bomb on you, be careful, like these Gakis. But what I wanted to show you, was waiting for this dude to die, is actually here in this poison hole, you can have the actually this type of enemy which you have not seen earlier. It's a toxic slime. I will explain you how you fight the toxic slime. It's quite easy. It's basically, it's super super easy. So there we go. This is a snake statue, and there is another enemy there. So let's kill that enemy first. Slime with a hand. Now you're gonna go for a one attack, second attack, opening. Morning moon. I just did it, right? Morning moon. One. Morning moon twice. And the statue is down. Look what happens. The poison pool disappeared. So there is no poison anymore here. Now we can go and pick up all these items here, which been sitting there. So this guy has died poison to death, which means he died from the damage over time. Because when the poison is being applied on you, it's going to tickle you over the time and you can die. However, you can prevent that from, you can prevent yourself from dying with from the poison or any sort of the damage over time, but I will just show you that when the time comes. Because right now we don't have access to that stat. What up, Game Paladinus? So, let's get back here. We got a toxic slime here. I'd rather not explain you anything. I mean, you can, it's quite obvious. You don't have too many attacks. So basically, you can just shoot those swords on you, and then he can just try to charge on you, as you can see. So watch this. As soon as he charge on you, he's going into the weak state. As soon as he get in a weak state, his yellow eye will pop up. Go in a high stance, strong attack. You knock him out of max key, and then you basically just grapple him, and he will die. Pretty much, you can actually shut that enemy. It's quite easy. Another Sudama here. Let's see what we don't need. Let's see. Don't give the salt. Don't give the dung balls to the Sudama. They're gonna get angry. I can show you what happens. So watch this. If I give the salt to her, yeah, it's Kodama. You're gonna get mad. Watch this. But watch this. That light in there can kill you. So yeah, be aware. Don't mess around. Don't give them. Just give them some item and they're gonna give you something in exchange. Be nice to them. They're gonna be nice to you. We got another range enemy here. You can kill it with bow. You don't need to do anything special. Yeah, exactly. Campalinus, right. Right when you resurrect. So the poison has disappeared as hell from here, right? Yeah, pick up some items here and there. So here we have what? You can summon the help if you need. Yes, like F4 increased frame rate. Yeah, there you see the big Gaki here, right? He's giving some warm welcome, shoot him in the head to do some max key damage. Right, quite easy, right? Yeah, download more RAM, exactly. So let's go on the right side first. Here we have a Nureona. You also have a bat. They can damage you. Well, they cannot kill you, but they can damage you. Oh, we have another Scampus here, so yeah, let's go. Okay, we have another Nureona here. Here we learn, we dodge that one. Quite easy. When she does this one, we block, right? With brute, you can just dodge and then try to follow up with your counter. Okay, one hand slam, hair slam, second one. Just try to show you. Another burst attack that she does. One. You want to dodge that one. You cannot block it. You cannot counter. You dodge the grapple. Quite easy, just wait for her and as soon as she like right before she starts charging, you can actually dodge through her and you're good. We kill her. Hey, what up, Tone? Okay, this roommate. Okay, we got some elixirs, nice, some rabbits from Ninja Hakama. Let's see what we can actually use here. Nice. Life, projectile damage taken, chin to Priestly. Well, let's use this one. And let's move on. Don't you get a musket? I might have it though. Yes, I got it. Just forgot to equip it. So here now we have a second range weapon. Musket. And now here we have a Yoki with a sword. Okay. That was my bad there. Because I could dart through him and I didn't. So I got hit. So when is the safe time to heal? Okay. He finished with these things. That's like opening for you to attack. You can actually use that instead to heal. You can also counter that as I did show you there. But you're gonna take damage. So you're rather not. So watch again. Now you wanna heal, right? Well, okay. Now we have opportunity to heal. I was expecting that follow-up. So I've already explained you how you fight these guys with a sword. So be aware, they have a lot of ki, especially every enemy in the Yoke Mist has a lot of ki. So why did we get here? We get here to destroy this statue, because I told you want to get rid of all the statue in this mission. So yeah, right now I'm slowly getting this Servant of the Gods Shinto Priest set, which is quite good. I explained why. I'm thinking of Bidas Campus Plus. Oh, you can. For me, it looks terrible. I don't know though. One Gaki, second Gaki. I think the Axel has it. What a Bumblebee? Oh yeah, I use it for the purpose of the guides. Bumblebee. That's the only reason. So let's destroy this. Morning Moon, one. Keepals, Morning Moon twice. Flux. Bit of flux too. We're good. We got two antidotes. Have a lot of 18 antidotes so far. And let's use this a little bit. I know it's a poison area, but I don't care. I just want to build up my ninjutsu here and there, because not all the enemies are... this enemy is actually, for example, resistant to poison. However, this enemy here as well will be resistant to poison. But again, there are some enemies like Enki which are not. See, for example here, I missed that counter and I got hit, which is not good. Right, so now I'm at a half HP, I wanna heal, right? What is the safe time to heal? This was a safe time, for example. One. You would not like to heal there. If you get good with your ki, you can just be a little bit more aggressive there, like I did. Heaven Flash, few strong attacks, sword ki, mist hands, quick attacks and so on. It's just practice, remember. This guy here. Bam. Pretty easy, right? Very simple. If you try to fight him and hit him normally when his yellow eyes inside him, he has a lot of defense and you will need like a 1 year probably to kill it. So let's get here, look around. Enki, right? This is save time to buff up my weapon, right? Not bad. You can see this weak on poison. Poison works on Enki. Yeah, you don't want to dodge that one. Move away from it. That one does hit 5 times. The first one he did was hitting the... actually 2 times. I'm just showing you what you can do early in the game in Ania as well. Well, you can basically try to play around with him, dodge one, block one, dodge one, block one as well. You know, just to try to learn the timing and so on. You know, just play around. Gaki here. What I did here? You have seen that running attack was fun, right? Can we imagine dodge cancel and spam? If the noob can handle that, uninstall exactly. Then yeah, you can actually dodge cancel that. Ball burst attack. Okay, another Ippon here. One, two. Okay, nothing. Let's see. Overhead. Overhead twice. Overhead three times. Sometimes you can do it once. Sometimes you can do it twice. See? Isn't that bad to break his horn and get some max key damage? Slam once. As you can see only. For example, comparing to Nureona, you cannot counter him after dodge. Knock him out of key. On few attacks, went for the Enki. Another Enki. So let's see. One, two, three. Opening. One, two, three. Opening. Quite easy. Quite easy. You don't want to be greedy. Wait for your openings. And you should be good. More than good, actually. If you are too greedy, if you run out of key. Why I'm telling you not to be greedy? You can get out of key. Let's say he's doing the 3 slam attack, you know that. And then you are trying to attack him, dodge, attack, dodge. And then you get out of key. And then he just slam you because you couldn't dodge because you had no key. Or perhaps you actually dodge all these three and you run out of key because you've been in the meanwhile trying to hit him or being greedy, and then you don't have time to punish him when you have an opening for that, for example. Oh yeah, the evasion cancel is super super useful, but it's just some advanced tech, so yeah. Usually here when you have another Nurikabe in this mission, and this is the NPC grave, which says crush to death Ben Rikabe for his neutral behavior, which means that he has used the yellow one. Okay, it's not blue. Feel free, it's red. Because you knew it's not yellow, so you have actually 100% chance to guess. Here, look around always, as I say. Here it used to be Poroka, but they removed it. So what do you want to do here? You're basically here. You can use that opportunity to kick this Gaki. Nobody can reach you here. Neither Nurana, neither this Yoki. They will not go around to you. Now we're in a dark realm, remember, our key recovery is slowed down. You wanna wait for this Nureona to go away. As soon as she go away, you go to the statue and try to destroy the statue. Why? The statue removes dark realm. And on top of that, okay, my bad. And on top of that, it removed the poison, which is quite useful. Okay, we did have time to kill, so I did heal there. Now we have two enemies here, which is not good. So you want to get rid of this motherfucker first. This little punk here. Why did I use this? You probably wonder why did I use that? So I don't get paralyzed. Just have some fun, paralyze. Just, you know, get some use of this Yoka shift. There. Could pop it up, it would just parry her for fun and kill her. So this is why I want you to destroy this statue first. It dispelled the dark crown and removed the poison. Now I can freely actually run away and fight these guys pretty easily. There you have a Yoki here. As you can see, he's out of key, right? What you can do, for example, can knock the portion of his max key by kicking him in the head. After the attack that he's been doing there, he can do the follow-up. So be aware. And then we killed him. Okay, we got another Dachi here. So we greet this dude, but we still don't understand what he's saying. So he, what does he say? He just wants something. Let's see, what do we don't need? I'm not using bombs. Let's give him some bomb. Okay, take the bomb. Might like it. Do you see? I gave him the bomb. Look what I got. A lot of items. Spirit stones. A lot of nice juicy items here. And Shrine was in the Dark Realm, so as soon as we dispelled the Dark Realm, Shrine was actually, we were able to use the Shrine. Okay, we got another Enki, another Yoki Soul Core, which is quite nice. They're higher level than the one we used to have. Let's use this Spirit Stones. Use all of them. And we got one Shifterling level, so what do we want to learn? We said we want to learn this, so yeah. Arcane of Light. We have got our first green skill, or I'm calling them the... I'm not calling them, they are called custom active skills. What are they? Why are they good? Are they not good? I'll just explain in a moment. So what are the active skills? So as you can see here, as I mentioned earlier, and near every skill you have this circle, which is allowing you to assign these active skills, but it's not free. And you can assign it free, but as you can see, key consumption rate 1.4. what does 1.4 mean? Like, what? Okay, let me just try to clarify that. 1.4 means your key consumption is increased by 40% on this same move when you use this Arcana of Light in this case, or this green skill on one in moon. So what does that mean? Let me try to show you here, but let's level up first before we get there. So let me go here. So pay close attention. I'm gonna do the morning moon. High stance. 5A2, right? So from the 1099 to 5A2. That's how much key it consumed, right? So let me show you something. Okay, cool. So right now we'll have the lightning on our move. But watch the key consumption. 457. It was 582, now it's a 457, which means it's a 40% increase. So cool, we have a lightning on this move, but it now this same skill costs 40% more key. Is it worth? I don't agree it is worth. If it was like a 15% of key, then could maybe speak. But almost the half, or a 50%, pretty much, in my opinion, it's not worth. So I do not suggest you using the green skills on a early game. You can use them if you are pretty good with the key management, but trust me, none of the people who start in this game is. So I can maybe use them because I know that I can recover a lot of key back with a key flex too, but I would not suggest that to the new people. I show you why. That was the reason why. It's increasing your key usage by 40%. For sake of what? Just to have a lightning imbue on your skill. don't think so it's worth it. Okay, sucker. That was absolute garbage. I hit there. Okay, we got one summary point here. What do you wanna learn now? We can learn another active skill, which I do not suggest. We can learn the flash attack, which is not bad. But we can also learn something else. Something like a key pulse man, maybe, or can learn the running heaven. Or maybe, I don't know. But let's get a flash attack. It's not necessary to have it, but it's a nice to have it as additional source of move. And also for you to, you know, get better with your weapon. So after an attack on your key pulse, you can trigger the flash attack. Each weapon has a unique flash attack, slower or faster, but this flash attack does a quite nice amount of damage. So for example, there you go, a use of the flash attack. Yeah. Let's put some poison here. Let's kill this Senki again. Forge you from behind. Get him down. Okay. Let's go to the shrine and let's move further. So I can just replenish back my HP. You don't need to kill the enemies over and over again, of course. So here we have a Nureona and we are hearing this sound, which is actually telling us the boss is near. So, Orns Blue, thank you for the follow, man. How are you doing? So, Nureona again. You have probably not seen, but I have seen that a freaking asshole of the blob is following me. So yeah, he tends to follow. I didn't want to kill him on purpose, so I can just show you that certain enemies will follow you down. Which you maybe don't want, actually. Because they can screw you up and you can die. So now we have two enemies, and for somebody new, it's not that easy to actually fight two enemies at once, especially when this dude is throwing the shit and this lady is constantly trying to attack you. So try to kill these particular enemies because they will follow you. So let's look around. Do we have anything around? Another item here around, and there should be a campus here as well. Yes, you want to get this campus before you enter in a fight. But there is a one place that I have not been there, so I would like to show you actually that place before I get to the boss. So just get here. It's this place here. I have not been there, so I would like to show you that place. So I gotta pick up this item here. Let's kill her again. A little bit of practice is always good. Arrow's opening there. Opening. Wait for her to attack. Opening. Enki. Okay, I kill her. Let's get here. As I said, always look around. If you wanna shoot in the head, you'll not be able to. She will hear the gun. I'll show you what will happen. Now I'll try to move here so she doesn't see me. We have one more Kodama here. We have almost missed. And you have another item there that we have also almost missed. So as long as you're not moving to the middle, she will not actually drop on you. One funny thing that we can test out actually is if you hold the block, will she drop on us or not? But let's say you have this bitch here. Don't use your gun, because you wanna wake up the other one, and if you have two of them, you're actually screwed. So get back here, try to kite this one or lure towards you. You don't want to fight there. Opening, few attacks. When she does that recovery, hold your block. Crazy, right? Okay. Right now, I'll show you what happens if you try to use the gun. If you don't use the bow, watch this. You see? She heard a gun, and then she dropped down instantly. If I was using the arrow, she would not hear the arrow, and I would knock her out of the max key, even. So avoid using cannons or matchlocks if the enemy is hanging like that, because they will hear you, and they will actually drop down, and you will not benefit. So try to use your arrows. So there is nothing special in here except that Kodama there that I just did pick. More antidotes, some more items. Nothing too in particular. But you know, it's nice actually to pick it up. There is one item that we have left off that I have not picked up, which is item. Where is the thingy? Yeah, it's item over here. So before you get to the boss, you can actually go there and pick up that item. Because why would you leave any item? Because you never know what that item will give you. And here was a shortcut that I have actually not used, but I suggest you highly to use this. As soon as you get here, get back, knock this thing down. You have a sort of the shortcut. So let's get back up. Have this shortcut here that we have open. You get another rifle ammunition. We're in there, that's cool. Oh fuck, not here of course. But yeah, he would saw me regardless, so cut him out. What up, sis? Kill this dude, just get some more shit from him. Hope you're doing good, sis. Get this motherfucker here. Could see what he does. There's a lot of bullshit, right? I didn't need to use this. I didn't use it. Good on you. I'm very good, man. Thank you for asking. So let's get back up here. Yeah. Up in other people. And now let's get here. Pick up this item. Up here. So I want to show you, see that I'm not dealing any damage at all on these guys when they are not in a weak state. So tie them, high stance, strong attack, which did miss. So yeah, pretty much. I think I'm missing one Kodama, which I honestly don't know where it is and where I have missed one Kodama. I think maybe in the beginning. It doesn't matter, like, I'm not here to show you how to get Kodamas. There is the other guys, the Kodamas. But yeah, I'm just trying to tell you that you can find a lot of Kodamas on your way. Try to collect all of them. So before you get inside this fight, make sure your Nima bar is full. Get this close campus. Let's heal up and let's get to the boss. There was an error in display in the chat. Thank you very much. Is the stream okay, guys? Okay. So let me just read that and I'm gonna get back on the bus. Hey, I'm from South Africa. I've been chasing the end late game for Nier, but I'm sure I'm missing a lot of hints to get to the stage where I'm at the moment. Build mess up Well, with a mission messed up. What a mission. On a side note. Yeah. So, Tien, I'll answer in a moment. Let me just finish this boss fight and explain to the people how to fight it. And as soon as I finish, I will actually attend and help you out. So we got to the snake. As soon as the fight starts, the snake will charge over you. You want to dodge that. So there is a few funny things with this snake. You can lock on the head. You can also lock on the body. So you can see, you can lock on the head on the body. You see those poles here? Those poles here were full of the poison. Since we have destroyed all the statues, actually all these poles are now empty and we have no problem whatsoever. So let's start with a boss. So as you can see, as soon as you enter, it will charge over you. You dodge that one. When she stabs the snakes in the ground, they will usually appear near you. So as you can see, you can basically dodge. You can dodge that, or you can just run. So when you see her stab the ground with the snakes, just dodge. The other move she has, or he has, I'm not even sure what sort of gender this is this sort of projectiles. So just run. You see, nothing will happen to you. You're fine if you run. What are you aiming in this fight? Is actually you are aiming to destroy her arms. I mean the boss arms, whatever. Why do you aim to destroy the boss arms? I will explain in a moment. You are dealing damage to the boss, and you are dealing increased key damage in key damage to the boss as well. And when he gets to the Dark Realm phase, he will not have the adds inside the Dark Realms, which are those hands. That was bullshit. So okay. So as we can see, just repeating the moves, summoning the projectiles, putting snakes in the ground, trying to pull me towards him, spitting out the poison pools, again doing the same shit. When he does this, you can use this as an opportunity. He can do that overhead attack, which can be pretty tricky. And this boss also can be pretty tricky to be countered with the brute attack. Again. You can destroy these hands by doing the Morning Moon. As you can see, those snakes on the side has their HP bars as well. So you can actually see how much HP they have left. Okay. I was lucky there. Watch this. Got a snake. You can also use a Mizuki to destroy them. I did leave one of them on a purpose, so you can see what happens when it gets to the Dark Realm. So if you don't destroy them outside of the Dark Realm, in a Dark Realm you gotta fight the snake plus those two little snakes. They can be pretty annoying. But as soon as you kill the little snake, you stagger the big one and you deal the damage, so the max key damage to him. As you can see on his head, you have that glowing Amarita that you can actually hit to deal additional max key damage. And in a Dark Realm, as you can see, his moves are, you know, kind of pretty much the same. With the exception that he tried to stab you with this just so sharp nose. When he does that charge over you, especially with a brute, you can actually just dodge it on the side and then, you know, just counter him. So I'm just trying to show you what attacks he has. Then he has a sweep tail attack, poison throw attack. See what happens there. Sometimes it happens that you miss with the burst counter. When he does the grapple, you can dodge it, but you can also get grabbed and die. So try to move away from it. Move away from it. Let him to finish. This is your opening to attack a few times. Opening to attack a few times. Soul Core to maximize the damage. The funny thing, watch this. Grapple him. Launch the yokai shift. Grapple him again. And you can keep up fighting in Yokai Shift and finish him off. This is like, I'm just showing you this so you can easily finish with this fight. I'll get out of the Yokai Shift, but I'll just show you there what you can do. So you can grapple him, launch the Yokai Shift immediately, and actually do another grapple. So basically bonus grapple. This attack can be tricky. It can pull you. It has a just awkward hitbox. So if you need to heal, there is the opportunity to heal. Forehead attack. Morning moon. Right now I have leaves those two snakes here. As you can see. See, both of them, they can be pretty annoying. So right now here, you would like to focus on the boss because the boss has a lower HP. But in a case the boss did not have the lower HP, you can actually just focus on a little snake. One morning moon. You kill the little snake if it's easier for you. And you're gonna deal the damage to your boss and kill the boss. So I'll show you the moves that this boss does. Comparing to an Enra, this boss has a quite easy moveset. The only thing you want to try to avoid is actually getting a Dark Realm with a two snakes of his. So you wanna try to destroy these snake hands as soon as possible. You can do them easily with a warning moon, for example, with katana or any sort of the high stance attack. The high stance attack, this one works. If you use Odachi, this one works. So any sort of the high stance attack will work there, or any attack that hits high so he can reach his hands. So you want to try at least destroy one hand before it gets to the Dark Realm. Or even both of them, which is great. What you can also use, I have not shown you, if it happens that you get in a Dark Realm there and you have a two snakes, you have time to launch the Mizuki. Launch Mizuki, you are going to kill or one shot both snakes immediately, or perhaps like deal insane amount of damage to them. So bear that in mind as well. So you can use Mizuki there. As soon as the Yuatsu no Kami gets in a Dark Realm, you can use the Mizuki to actually smack down those ugly snakes and deal some damage, as to the max key damage, and have opportunity to punish him further. As you have seen there, when I put him in a grapple state, I did show you. Grapple him, Yokai Shift immediately, and you have another free grapple. On this boss in particular, I don't think so there is a... Yeah, there is no other boss that this works on. So I did just show you, and you can keep up yourself in a Yokai Shift actually there and try to finish off the boss. I did get out of it on a purpose so I can show you the rest and how it looks like when you have two snakes in a Dark Realm. Pretty much, as I said, his moveset is quite easy comparing to an Enra. When he does the grapple, move away. When he does that tail, overhead tail smash, you can either dodge it, it's not that hard. It's, as I say, it can be tricky boss, it can be annoying. Luckily, they fixed his tracking. He used to have a bullshit tracking at the beginning, at the release, so right now he's actually quite easy. Welcome back. So, okay, let's exit and let me help the TN. So it's 8:05. I'll not do any other main mission because it's gonna take me another 2 hours probably, which I don't have. So this will be it for with a today mission. So I'll just try to help out the TN. I'll just show you some videos. We're gonna chat a little bit more, and then I'll be dropping from for today. Because I would like to have, you know, every full mission done, at least, you know, as a part.
No.
So, Tien, you said and late game, you need some build, right? Or you need information, or you looking for tips and so on. Because if you're looking for tips or having a lot of questions, I can actually just point you right away to our new community, which is basically, you know, 24/7. There are always people who are awake because we are for different time zones, and they can offer you the help, answer the question, and also give a tip or showcase or give you the video or point you toward the right location. If you have a lot of questions, let me just type it for you. So we have a Neo Discord. Neo Discord. So just get there, accept the rules. After 10 minutes, you'll be able to speak. Feel like at home. Check out the channels, check out the rules. It's actually, you know, nothing demanding. Just, you know, be polite, be respectful. And that's all, you know. You can ask as many questions as you want and get as many tips as you want. And there are a lot of skilled players in this game who knows a lot. So yeah. Information concerning the equipment. I don't understand the plus value on equipment and I don't see improvement or changes. I'm just blind. Okay, I will explain you in a moment. This community is almost as good as the game itself. Thank you very much, Taco. Man, I love this cutscene. It's so good, man. So fucking good cutscene. His last breath. Did he kill at least one? You okay? Yeah. Dōsan-sama. Dame datta ga. No, he did. You can pay me for the service later. At the moment I have a troll build, but see how high I can push my max HP. Just shit as a giggle. How much HP do we have at the moment? I'm only the DLC away from the NG++. So you are on a dream of the demon at the moment, right? Shiro Hami. Got another guardian spirit. And this one is another brute guardian spirit that we have received here. And now we have got some Shinto priest. We have got Yatsunokami. Yatsunokami is actually quite good soul core. Let me just get back my camera. So Yatsunokami is a quite good soul core. It costs 8 anima. It takes 10 slots. But it's a really does the really nice hit damage. So I can suggest you to use that one as well. Okay, we have unlocked some missions, we have got some titles, blah blah blah. All the thingies. Let's get a key recovery here. We have got one skill point here, so let's learn the EI quick draw too. Here, and what do we got? We got spirit stones, nothing special. Now we can go to the second region. But let's first level up, let's do the dojos. But before that, I would like to help out the TN first. Get this one, we can get this one. So TN, can you please wait for me just to finish this so I can swap to my other character, then I can show you the things. Not started yet, Dream of the Strong. Dream of the Strong is NG+. To have a base game, NG+, Dream of the Strong. Then NG++, Dream of the Demon, NG+3, Dream of the Wise, NG+4, Dream of the Neo. That's how it goes, actually. So here, hidden tea house. I'm in a Toto clan here. So Toto clan, it's not bad. But it's not useful for me at this time. So I will swap down from this Toto clan right away to Ukita clan. So if you wonder why I will swap to Ukita clan here, I will just explain in a moment why. So Ukita clan here, it's a quite nice, it's going quite nicely with a Shinto preset. Because it's giving you life recovery and purification 200. And plus, damage taken over time, it's reduced by 40%. Damage over time, if you remember, it's a fire dot. and a poison dot. So those two are damage over time. So the damage you're receiving from the poison, those tickles, are actually reduced by 40%, which is quite good on the beginning, especially. So let's pick up this one. And update. So this is the clan we are going to use from now on, at this character, at least. Dojo missions. We have unlocked the Way of the Ninja of Ice and Way of the Omnio right now. So you also want to finish both of these so you can unlock the further skills and get some Ninja and Omnio locks. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a nice amount of HP. You can use Total Clan to increase it even further at the end. So let's finish this punk off. And then I'll do the rest of the things. So what do we have here? Yeah, he's gonna summon me some bullshit. Ninja locks, get there, learn the shuriken, go to your shrine. I don't understand this because I learned the shurikens already, but you know, it's just a game thing. Ready Jitsu, now it's explaining that you can assign something that I have already shown you. You can get 8 shurikens if you want. And cool, we have put the shurikens there, we assign it to our first lot, cool. We get out and we're gonna summon the enemies. Or maybe not. I think he will summon the enemies, yeah, of course. So watch this. Yeah. Yeah. That's fun, right? We kill him. That's it. I would kill him faster with a sword than with these shurikens. But yeah, as you can see, the shurikens are staggering the little humans, so that's a nice thing that I wanted to show you here by tossing the shurikens back on him. That was one dojo. And we're going to do the one more dojo, which is the Omnia dojo. Again, it's gonna give, you know, I have learned, I have shown you this already, but you know, the dojo missions are somehow weird, they're asking us to do this. So let's get back here, pick up the lock. If you wonder how my lock is automatically being used, I'll just show you that right away. So if you go in the basic settings here, you can find automatically use acquired lock of hair, which is life saver in my opinion, so I would suggest you highly use that one and set it on. Let's get back to the tree, Omnia tree, learn the purification talisman, go back to your shrine, attach it. We've already done this. Thank you very much, Toshiro. All three of them. That has a shortcut. Cool. Right, we did it. Now we can proceed further. Let's apply that purity. Gaki. You very good have a skills here. You already know this enemy. Finish it off and you know that's done. Pretty much. And I can just exit this. And you gotta do the dojos. The only reason, as I said, is to unlock the further skills which are locked there under these dojos. Pretty much. Mm-hmm. You got some Omni locks here with some ninjutsu locks. I said we wanna learn antitoxin pill. I'm gonna get that right now. I did explain why that is important. And right now here, I want to learn the key pulse man as well. As so the other things, dodge at a perfect timing will automatically trigger key pulse. Not a big deal, we can get it, but let's get this one. Key pulse man, and here, we said we want to get to gas talisman, right? Let's get a gas talisman. And we can set up that all here at the shrine. Burai Jitsu. You don't have any more slots, but you can always put two of these and then, you know, add this one or maybe one of these and add this one. It's absolutely up to you. Put some antitoxin pills here instead of this. And we are good here. So, as I said, we have done the wall the Viper Sanctum mission. I will not attend to the next region yet. I will do that on my next stream. There's gonna be the part 3 of this guide. As I said, I will not do these Twilight missions. The side missions, because it's not necessary for this guide unless that side mission has a boss that we did not have in main missions. However, this would be it for the guide series and the part 2 for today. I will upload this as well on YouTube. I will put the timestamps on everything that I have been speaking of, all the crucial parts, all important things. It's gonna be out probably on a next Monday. I think it was Monday. The same day when the first part was released, so it's gonna be on a Monday. So right now that I have done with this, I want to help out and show the